Hello, and welcome to the Transportation Planning Capacity Building video series. This video series is sponsored by the Transportation Planning Capacity Building Program, jointly administered by the Federal Highway and Federal Transit Administrations. I'm Ben Turpin, and I'm pleased to introduce Chandra Ingalls Smith, Transportation Specialist at FHWA Office of Planning.
Hello, everyone.
Introduction.
If you are a transportation planner at the state, regional, or local level, or work closely with a transportation planning agency, this video will explain the processes and practices you will engage in as you become involved in transportation planning. As you work through these processes, you should look to the FHWA FTA Transportation Planning Process Briefing Book as a resource and guide. We will reference the briefing book as we move through the planning process.
The typical transportation planning process, as outlined in the briefing book, is illustrated by the graphic on your screen. Note, however, that the process we will discuss is approximate, as the steps in transportation planning are more complex, overlapping, and malleable than can be captured in one chart or outline. The transportation planning process must be flexible in order to respond to changing circumstances, new demands, or shifting public expectations.
If you are involved with the transportation planning process, you will want to make sure that the process, at a minimum, covers the following six core functions. Establish a setting for effective decision-making. Identify and evaluate transportation improvement options. Prepare and maintain a long-range or approximately 20-year statewide or metropolitan transportation plan known as SLRTPs and MTPs. Develop a statewide or regional transportation improvement program known as STIPs or TIPs. Identify performance measures and targets and monitor whether implemented programs are achieving targets, and involve the public.
In addition to these typical steps, there are common issues that run through the planning process. These can serve as benchmarks for each step of the process. Common foundational elements include equity, sustainability and resilience, safety, connectivity and access, environmental justice, efficiency, and public engagement. All planning activities should take these issues into consideration and incorporate them into the planning process. As we progress, we will highlight these issues within each step of the planning process. Additionally, using an in-practice example, we will follow the course of a hypothetical project as it moves through each step of the transportation planning process. Steps.
From the briefing book and the graphic shown earlier, we are using these seven steps to illustrate the transportation planning process. Keep in mind that to accommodate the complex realities of the real world, the process is often less straightforward than is presented here. The seven steps are: establish vision and goals. Identify improvement strategies. Evaluate and prioritize strategies. Develop a transportation plan. Develop a transportation improvement program. Implement the transportation plan. And operate the system.
Let's go through each of these steps one by one at the MPO level. Establishing vision and goals.
The first step in the transportation planning process is to define your vision and your goals. An example of a community's vision is what members of that community might want it to look like in the next 20 years, while goal statements address specific issues and aspirations. The vision and goals will vary depending on your organization, your location, and the needs of the community. While every community's vision and goals may differ from one another, the process of establishing them can be similar.
When establishing your vision and goals, planning organizations should address certain established planning factors per 23 CFR section 450.306, scope of the Metropolitan Transportation Planning Process. That regulation states that the Metropolitan Transportation Planning Process shall be continuous, cooperative, and comprehensive, and provide for consideration and implementation of projects, strategies, and services that will address the following factors. Support the economic vitality of the metropolitan area. Increase the safety of the transportation system. increase the security of the transportation system, increase accessibility and mobility of people and freight, protect and enhance the environment, promote energy conservation, improve quality of life, and promote consistency between transportation improvements. Enhance the integration and connectivity of the transportation system across and between modes. Promote efficient system management and operation. Emphasize the preservation of the existing transportation system. Improve the resiliency and reliability of the transportation system. And enhance travel and tourism.
When establishing your vision and goals, community engagement is key. Your organization should conduct outreach across communities in your areas, ensuring that all voices are heard. There are many engagement methods, including public meetings and hearings, workshops, charrettes, and town halls, social media outreach, engagement with community groups and local organizations, pop-up outreach, and virtual public involvement. For more information on FHWA's Virtual Public Involvement Initiative, see the FHWA's VPI website.
These are just a few of the methods that can be used, and an effective community engagement strategy should employ multiple methods. It is imperative that communities whose voices are often not heard within planning processes are engaged in meaningful ways. These communities may include those with limited English proficiency, rural communities, racial minorities, and other marginalized groups. For more information on conducting equitable public outreach, see the FHWA site on environmental justice in the US DOT Equity Action Plan. For our in-practice example, let's look at the Plannersburg MPO, which is a single county MPO consisting of the city of Plannersburg and the county of Plannersburg. The MPO is working with the city to update their vision for their transportation system. Plannersburg MPO and city staff began a public engagement process, reaching out to communities throughout their city. Through this engagement, they identify the community members' desire a wider array of non-vehicular transportation options that connect all parts of the city. They establish a goal: to build connections via more sustainable transportation options. Identify improvement strategies.
In this next step, your organization will build upon the vision and goals developed in the previous step to identify the needs and gaps that can be addressed through various strategies. These strategies may be capital projects, like adding a roundabout, or a program, like developing complete streets policies or guidance for local agencies. You will compare the vision and goals against existing and future conditions within the planning area to identify possible strategies that are responsive to current conditions and will continue to be relevant into the future. In practice example, the MPO staff work with partner agencies, synthesize the result from the previous community engagement, their analysis of the planning area's existing conditions, and their understanding of anticipated future conditions to identify a range of non-vehicular strategies that would improve connectivity. The MPO recommends strategies to expand the sidewalk network, construct bike lanes and additional bicycle infrastructure, expand the bus service, and add e-scooter and bike share services.
Evaluation and prioritization of strategies. After identifying improvement options, those strategies must then be evaluated and prioritized to align with available resources and community interests. Prioritization is a cooperative process among states, MPOs, and transit operators for identifying projects and strategies from the most recent 20-year Long-Range Metropolitan Transportation Plan, or MTP, that are sufficiently high priority and ready for delivery to be included in the TIP. What strategies will best align with your organization's vision or goals? What strategies will be the most popular or impactful to your community? What strategies are the most cost-effective or efficient? These are some of the questions you will be asking yourself as you move through this process.
To answer those questions, you will evaluate the strategies via a defined set of metrics and performance measures. These metrics will vary across locations and agencies, but commonly include mobility, equity, environmental justice, access, safety, sustainability, connectivity, cost-benefit, or alignment with existing plans, laws, and state and federal guidance.
When you are going through the prioritization process, you will want to continue engaging the public. Be sure to follow your public participation plan and pay particular attention to seek fairness in meeting the needs of all community members, including low income, environmental justice, and minority communities who have often been overlooked in past transportation planning processes. It is crucial that you engage previously overlooked communities when prioritizing strategies. There are a number of executive orders as well as the Civil Rights Act of 1964, which can help you address these issues. For more information, see the USDOT webpage on transportation equity. In practice example, staff for the Plannersburg MPO convene a committee of representatives from local agencies, the state DOT, and environmental and economic development organizations to prioritize the strategies that they previously developed through the planning process. The committee applies the evaluation criteria that were developed in advance and aligned with the goals of the MTP. They evaluate benefits, trade-offs, costs, liabilities, project readiness, and community engagement responses, including outreach to marginalized communities. They then rank strategies to align with available resources. These recommendations are presented to the MPO Policy Committee that will ultimately decide what strategies to include in the plan. Development of Transportation Plan.
Once strategies are evaluated and prioritized, they are combined with additional information, data, comments, projects, and/or studies into the Metropolitan Transportation Plan. This plan may incorporate additional public comments, peer agency input, prioritized strategies, an updated vision, and air quality analysis. The plan will include detailed information on capital projects, proposed policies, operational strategies, and funding mechanisms.
This process has many steps itself. Along the way, there are regular check-ins with peers, other agencies, and the public to receive feedback and guidance on plan development. As you develop the plan, make sure it aligns with the established transportation factors found in 23 CFR Section 450.306, which dictate that the planning process shall be continuous, cooperative, and comprehensive.
In practice example, Plannersburg develops a comprehensive MTP incorporating performance metrics intended to measure safety, connectivity, and air quality, among other factors. This document provides a long-range vision for the planning area and lays out the vision, goals, strategies, and priorities. It also defines performance measures, as well as project, program, and policy recommendations. Within the plan, complete street strategies are prioritized, and bike lanes are highlighted as a project recommendation. General information, including potential location and broad design guidance, is included.
Development of transportation improvement programs. From the longer-term, larger-scale transportation plan that you developed in the previous step, a short-range performance-driven transportation improvement program is developed that includes priority transportation improvements. The TIP implements the long-range transportation plan. Programs include funding for projects over a four-year period. The TIP at the MPO level, or STIP, at the statewide level, represents immediate priority actions to achieve the area's goals and associated system performance targets.
These performance targets are often defined by law and by their own regulations. For additional information about these laws and the relationship between TIP and STIP, please refer to the Transportation Planning Capacity Building Briefing Book.
In practice example, as part of the TIP development process, the Plannersburg Public Works Department submits a proposal to implement one of the plan recommendations located in their city. They develop a bike lane project proposal for consideration in the TIP that includes detailed information, locations, specifications, budgets, funding sources, timelines, and cost estimates for environmental review, design, and construction. Implement the transportation plan.
Projects recommended in the MTP are programmed in the TIP for funding and then move toward implementation. Project design, public meetings, and environmental review take place as the project gains additional depth and detail in the development process.
When the project and funding receive approval to be programmed in the TIP and STIP, The entity managing and building the project can move forward towards preliminary engineering, design, right-of-way, and construction. Contracting and construction practices vary between states, organizations, and municipalities, so you'll want to consult your agency's contracting and construction management guidelines for more information.
In practice example, the project is included in the TIP, and the local public works department begins work to design and build the facility. The city secures a landscape architecture and engineering consultant to move forward with designing the bike lane. During the design process, the city pursues environmental clearance and obtains required permits. Once the design and environmental review are completed, the land necessary for the bike lane is purchased and the project is put out to bid. A contractor is selected and construction commences.
Systems operation. The final step is systems operation. Once construction is complete, a project becomes an operable element of the transportation system. Ongoing monitoring and evaluation of the transportation system informs future planning work. As projects are built that improve safety, reduce travel time and congestion, and provide more multimodal options, travel patterns change and these can be identified and assessed in planning for continual improvement of the transportation system.
In practice example, the construction of the bike lane is completed and it opens to the public. The city monitors the project in order to find out if the project meets the initial goal of diversifying transportation options beyond personal vehicles. Surveys are conducted with the public to gauge their response. It is deemed a success, and it is used as a case study for their plans to further expand their bike lane network.
Summary. The transportation planning process can vary across organizations and geographies. It does not always follow a linear path, and there are often unexpected complexities that arise as the process unfolds. However, the planning process outlined in this video provides a generalized description that can help familiarize you with a typical process that you may encounter at a transportation planning organization. For more information about this topic or any other topic in this video series, please visit the Transportation Planning Capacity Building website at planning.dot.gov. Please note that except for the statutes and regulations mentioned, the content of this video does not have the force and effect of law and is not meant to bind the public in any way. This video is intended only to provide information and clarity to the public regarding existing requirements under the law or agency policies.